Archaeology Event 2020 in Forge of Empires. Last year, the Archaeology Event was very popular, so it comes back this year. It got a bit spiced up, and of course, there are new unique rewards. Just as last year, the main task is to collect ancient scrolls. It starts with an initial stock of 120 scrolls, and the first lock-in every day provides another 50 scrolls. More scrolls can be found in the incidents in and around the city. Then there is the usual long quest line. The initial 39 rush quests provide 60 scrolls each. The 21 daily quests provide 80 scrolls each. The last quest even 100 scrolls. Especially the long productions should be planned wisely, and it helps to have enough production buildings. My two production buildings of the current age plus three blacksmiths definitely were not enough. And it can happen that suddenly all taverns are filled completely, as all players need tavern visits simultaneously. But this can be less of a problem as players play their normal world more active than the beta server. In total, the number of scrolls is more than enough. Everybody will be able to have the airship on the highest level. The risk might be that the incomplete second airship can motivate to invest diamonds to complete it. But with a total of 11 levels, it is still a long and expensive development. The scrolls are then used to trade them for tools. It is recommended to always buy the biggest tool set only. Do not buy single tools. With these tools, you can then move forward in the excavation. Brushes are for the detail work. Use them to remove sand from a single tile. With a shovel, a complete column can be cleared, and dynamite removes the sand from all surrounding tiles. Don't worry, explosions will not destroy the relics. Instead, the sand is removed and you will be able to collect the previously covered item. The effect of shovels and dynamite ends at walls, so use them wisely. Discovering a relic isn't enough. The sand must be removed first before it can be moved to the inventory. In most cases, the brush will be the right tool, but sometimes a shovel or dynamite can help better. During your excavations, you will find more tools, but also vases that contain rewards that we already know from many other events. There is a small chance to receive the daily special instead. One of these daily specials is a popular carousel. Besides that, many well-known buildings are offered as daily specials, including the previous year's grand prize, the World Exhibition. For me, the number of upgrades was not enough for bringing it to level 10, but other players succeeded. Luck is still a relevant factor in this. Besides that, there is a completely new building among the daily specials, the Globe Fountain. It is beneficial to only collect scrolls for a while and to use them when the offered daily special is interesting. I concentrated on the golden idols. As I found out later, everybody receives so many scrolls and tools that even those artifacts can be collected, which are not in the shortest way for your progress. This will be a very relaxed event. But do not underestimate the required time for this minigame. It took more than 1 hour to complete my excavations. In the end, I had many different rewards, including several hundred forge points. This will be an accelerator, especially for new cities. 20 golden idols are required to receive a grand prize, example given the upgrade kit for the airship. You will receive the airship as a reward for completing quest 5. The first 3 upgrade kits become available with the milestone of the quest line, and all others will be received from the minigame, where every second grand prize is an upgrade kit. As mentioned before, you will receive more upgrade kits than needed. Everybody will be able to get the airship up on level 11. On this highest level, it will provide population, but not happiness. On top, it adds coins, supplies, 15 goods of the current age, 8 forge points, plus another 15 goods for the guild treasury. The airship has exactly the same 7x3 size as the ship, but it provides more goods and forge points if motivated. By the way, motivated buildings cannot be plundered. During the excavations, you will also find clay tablets. Each can be used to start a little extra quest line. I recommend to collect these clay tablets and to start all of them simultaneously. It took very long until I found the last missing clay tablet, a silver one, while I already had all others several times. These are random effects, but it is possible that it also depends on how carefully the excavation is done. In all these areas that I left hidden, more clay tablets might have been. All these mini quest lines have similar quests. Complete one, and all others will also be completed if they are active at that moment. The best example of this is a 4-hour production quest. Nobody wants to start all these many 4-hour productions for 6 quests individually. Do it once, and all 6 quests are completed. The first 4 quests of each mini quest line give a reward of 5 scrolls. The final quest will then provide a nice small extra reward. For completing all 8 mini quest lines, the historian reward is granted, a toolset plus an avatar. Some more avatars can be achieved through the excavation and the main quest line. I enjoyed this event a lot in beta. A possible reason might have been that it was very relaxed. I think we all can be happy that this great event is coming soon.